the older family. All welcome here to country. In that language, what I've said is that you come, my country. The ancestor spirit will be with us, you know?
I came to the Elders Council with an idea about fish monitoring. It just made sense that we had common values about caring for country, how we might do that, but how we also might collaborate.
We're on Orpheus Island Research Station on Manbarra Sea Country. We're connecting with the traditional owners of this sea country, co-designing a research project.
When you say that you've got data from the 80s, then I'm wondering, is that data when potentially country was healthy?
We don't know if it was healthy then, because it had already had a lot of human impact and especially European impact. So maybe somewhere in your collective memories or in your stories, there is more information about what should be in sea country, what used to be there, you know?
We would talk about, fishing back in the day and how healthy country was then.
It was plentiful, yeah. No matter what, even to stuff with the mangrove, like peppies and all those things were plentiful. You won't find that today. Yeah. What does that tell you?
Yeah, we've got seagrass along here, but not much.
Just put a green dot there.
The place where I thought it was all done grass, because we're unfertile, it was just all dead coral. But it was, alive a few years ago, because I used to dive along there.
Is this all reef in here? Is
it just reef.
Just reef?
It's a fantastic result. Look at this beautiful map. It's not just a combination of our current state of knowledge. It's basically the best possible design for this project. We also learned a lot about how the environment has changed through time. And we've also learned about some really sensitive story places that, we're very fortunate that we're allowed to still consider doing study in that area, but of course with the sensitivity of knowing, treat those places very carefully and make sure that we notify elders before we go into those places.
I think in terms of Australia's history, there was a time when we not only didn't have voice, but sometimes we did not have choice. Reconciliation action plans are a part of the landscape that we have. This is the next step in terms of how do we live that out.
We have been working in their sea country, not just without their permission, but without their knowledge. We've gathered all this information that could be of use to them that we're not giving to them. We want to do better, and this is part of learning to do better and to be more, not just inclusive, but to have them guide us. It is also the start of the ranger program for them. This project is what will kickstart that ranger program.
So we're starting in the lab, in the computer lab, talking about the remote underwater video station, which is really a fancy name for a camera that goes in the sea. We're going to go out into the field. We'll drop some cameras in so that they can also get a really good feel for what it feels like to do that, how heavy they are, how they work.
There's a great unknown about the health of our sea country. With this program, there's a potential that we can have an audit. We have a story that we have on Manbarra country. One of the principles of this story, the solution was found in country. What's in country is actually people with knowledge who might provide us with the necessary information, the ability to navigate this space with a better understanding. The blessing that we find is that, organisations like AIMS, organisations like JCU, organisations like the Research Centre have put up their hands and said, hey, can we be on the journey with you? And that's for me, is a beautiful thing.